beyond the sleep of life, beyond the reach of dawn? What could possibly await us? And yet we seek it insatiably, such as our fate.
You should be angry. I'm with you. You should have been angry about that. There was nothing fun about that.
White sign, soapstone.
You got it?
I got it.
Sweet. So I'm gonna go ahead and...
He could have gave me that before.
He could have. I'm gonna grab mine real quickly, and then we can head on the boss of this place.
You don't want me to try to help you with it?
I don't need help with the boss, although I can if you want, like, extra practice with it.
The area over here.
Oh, I mean, I got through the rest of these areas pretty... I've got some tricks. I didn't lead you the way that I normally go. That makes it a little bit easier, because I wanted you to kind of experience things in a certain way.
Ah.
But I can get
so
through
you,
it.
You want me to struggle?
I do. I want you to feel the struggle, man. Is that too much for a man to ask?
I don't know, man. I don't know.
How do you feel now? Do you feel fulfilled? Do you feel stronger, like a better person?
I feel like I'm going to be checking the textures of all of these walls a little bit harder.
You're probably going to be, man. I'm glad to hear that, because that's the way that the original Dark Souls was. People went fucking crazy over it.
Man, I'm just running through everywhere we've already been, smacking X on all these walls.
I probably would have just here. I'm not gonna spoil anything, but just know that I probably would have pointed it out earlier if there was one there, and did the same thing with you.
Okay.
So well, far, I think it's safe like to say that you're all right.
All right. Well, you just saved me a lot of time in wall smacking.
I imagine that I just did, yes.
The texture on the wall told me... Oh my god, okay. I don't think I'm ever gonna, like, get over this.
Yeah, you've got so much to learn, young Padawan, let me put it like that. Alright, I have almost gotten my soapstone. I kind of want to run back and get an Estus flask real quickly, so I have three like you do, and then we can go face the boss with our signs.
You have three?
Well, I have two right now, but I'll get the third one from the place where you saw the pursuer the first time.
Wow. Okay, well, I have two.
Well,
I have one. I have one. I haven't gone back yet.
Yeah, you haven't gone back. You should have two shards. You're fine.
I'm a little mad that after all that, I still don't have 4,000 souls.
Still don't have 4,000 souls. I probably would at this point if I had...
I would have if I didn't buy that key.
Well, no, the key's important. I don't know if you read the description of the key at all.
Yeah, it opens up the blacksmith.
That's right.
The blacksmith stuff. Huh. I never noticed this little step thing you do after you roll forward and you hold back.
The little step thing you do when you roll forward?
You roll forward and you pull the analog stick back at the same time. You do like a little weird step thing.
You mean like a back step?
No. You run forward, roll forward,
okay.
Mid-roll, pull back on the analog stick.
What does it do? Does it do something to your roll or something?
No, it does something to your stop. It cuts it just a tad short.
Oh, that's weird. Tips and tricks for Dark Souls, man. Something I never knew.
Yeah, it's not much.
Right.
But it's like enough to keep you from getting hit if you think you're gonna like roll directly into a smack or something.
I gotcha. Alright, so let me, I've got my third Estus shard. So I'm going to set my, are you back at the bonfire now or where are you at?
I'm still at Pate.
You're still at Pate, okay. Is there any way you can run yourself back to the bonfire?
Yep.
All right.
Am I resting or am I?
No, no. Don't rest. Don't rest. Just let me put my sign down, my real sign, so that I can take you through the rest of the level here.
All right.
All right. Enough with this. Enough with this dinky ass small sign soapstone bullshit.
There's this guy here named Sir Fuzzy Buns.
Is it really Sir Fuzzy Buns? You know, congrats to Sir Fuzzy Buns. He's leaving the community alive. I like that.
Indeed.
Okay, so if you're at the bonfire, go to the corner that is like the corner of the staircase, and there should be my summon sign there.
Alright, I'm just gonna do the two step till I hear the whoa, what's up.
I really do like, and like if you are waiting, like use the camera to kind of clip into your character, like look at the armor and the sword. Like they really did, like if I look at the pommel of my sword, there's like a ton of fucking detail in the actual hilt of it. They did a lot of like,
oh yeah,
they put a lot of detail work into the actual armor and weapon sets in this game.
I could see that, like on my my left shoulder, I got like battle scars on it.
Exactly. It's some serious shit, man. There's a lot of cool armor sets in the game, but my favorite one I think we'll find much later in the game is the set from the front cover.
Okay. Looking forward to it.
Are you summoning me yet, man?
Summoning you right now. It just showed up.
There we are. Don't you be leaving old.
I just realized my character is small.
Don't you be leaving old Mecha Will in the wrong spot. I don't. You know, I'm here to help. All right.
That little rumble when I summon you.
I know. Like, it means shit's about to get serious. All right. So everybody's still alive, right? Everybody's dead, right?
Everybody's dead.
All right, now that we got the time, follow me. Let's go do some logistical shit. This is, you know, we got to show you the ups and the downs of this game. Why don't you follow me?
All right.
Now, this is going to be a little tricky. Come to about this point in time. Do a little jumpy out onto this little cliff here. You can just roll. You don't have to jump roll, but I like jump rolling.
Yeah, okay.
All right, this is a whole new area to explore. There's, well, not a whole new area, but an area we definitely need to drop down. I think there might be an item down here somewhere. I'm not sure. I know there's definitely an enemy here.
Oh, is he dead?
Yeah, I got him.
Oh, he dropped an item. That's good.
Oh, okay, sweet.
Oh, I want the item.
Is there an item back there?
No, it was the thing that the guy dropped.
I see.
Armor.
All right. Well, then we need to go back up. We're gonna have you meet a very important NPC.
Okay. I would assume that he is important.
Oh, okay. All right. Sorry. I thought I wasn't gonna make that jump for a second.
Where did you jump to?
I'm over here.
I see you over there.
Don't leave me here.
I see you over there.
I'm gonna get sniped.
You left me.
Why don't you keep up with the rest of the pack? All right. Now we've dropped.
I thought I was the only one who did that.
Have you ever been in here before? Let me just ask that first.
In here?
Yeah.
From what I recall, in ancient years past, there was a man who liked some maps.
That's correct. All right. Well, you first.
I hear noises. Oh! Oh! All right.
Almost got you there. I saw you.
All right. Where did this even go?
There's a hole. It's just gone, man. This is totally gone.
I almost ran directly for that item.
I feel you, man. Why do you come up here and talk to this fine gentleman and grab your key? While you're doing that, I'll give you a little bit of backstory. Basically, every NPC in this place seems to have forgotten the reason that they've come to this land, the land of Drang Lake, the land of brimming with hollows and souls.
I see that's a common thing there. Even the merchant doesn't remember why he's here.
Exactly, common theme. You're one of the Firelink or the Firekeepers at the start of the game said that you're going to be wandering Drang Lake. You know, you're going to get to the doors of the castle and you're going to be here, not knowing why you came here. So we're going to, you know, we're in a sense, we're losing our own purpose as well. But everybody that comes to this land is, you know, kind of forgetting, you know, why they're here and what they're here for. And that is very much tied to the undead curse and its effects on the people. This land is in a state of, like, this is, like, in Dark Souls 1, it was, like, right after the fire went out. So, like, you know, there was still, it was, like, when hollowing was, like, really a big concern. There was, like, the curse was new and everything. This game is, like, after the fire has, like, you know, been out for, like, a long time. You know, everything's starting to fall apart. Okay. You know, kingdoms have fallen. You know, everything's in disrepair and rubble. And we'll start to learn why as we move on.
Okay. Everything's falling apart.
The voice acting in this game as well, with the rest of them, is pretty fucking absurd.
Oh, yeah. And you just assume that behind the maps too. Oh, you gave me a key to your house.
That's right.
All right, that's cool.
Isn't that how it always works? You talk to a random stranger for 5 seconds, and he gives you the key to his place of residence. That would be a real problem with our society if that were the case. People aren't as nice as you or me.
Nobody would ever be able to.
Yeah, definitely not the best.
Exactly. Movie.
So out there, I don't think is the way to go. You want to run back down here?
No, that was an item.
Oh, okay.
A couple items over here.
Well, follow me and don't get lost.
Ha ha ha.
Follow me.
As you run, like, out of eyesight.
And you'll find a world of pure imagination.
Did you go up this ladder? You're...
Rinse and find... That's something, something. Da da da, da da da, da da da, da 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 da.
Why are you running from me?
Come on over here, man. I'm not. I'm tired of babysitting. Let's go.
All right, let's do this.
Grab some. Grab a little item here.
Porch. Yeah.
Where are we going here? That's the wrong way.
Crap. Okay, I'm going back around.
Did you just fall? No, that might be the right way. Yeah. I don't think there's anywhere else to go here.
Well, there's a couple of items over there. Let's do this. Okay. Well, that works.
Oh yeah, down on the
Oh
yeah.
God.
Down on the bayou. All right, you got to take care of this shit yourself, man. It's all you. Be a good boy. Put those skills into play. Oh, there's actually two of them down there.
Yeah, I noticed.
That's all right. You can play it calm. You got one of them. Roll away. That's right, dude. I like spectating you. All right. That's right. Apply some pressure. There you go. He's gone. That's my man, TCM Black. Now come with me and explore a world of pure imagination, please.
Oh, okay. Well, where are we going? There's another item over there.
And you'll be in a world of pure imagination.
Alright, I'm trying to figure out how to get down. Okay, this is... How do I get back? Oh, okay, I see it now.
How do I get that?
No, back.
Oh, yeah, you gotta go, like, on the path... I totally left you in the dust, man. I thought better of you. I thought maybe you'd be able to handle it, but no, I'm coming.
I'm back. No, I'm fine. I'm not lost. I know where I am. I'm back on the tree bridge.
I'm already on my way back, man. You can't hide from me.
I'm already on the tree bridge. I'm here.
Back in the New York groove?
Yes, that one.
That was a popular song by Ace Frehley, a split-off member of the band Kiss when the band broke up and they decided to do their solo records.
Oh.
And I'm back in the New York groove. You know, do you not remember that tune?
I don't.
Okay, it's probably not your style. It's it's an odd song for sure.
You killed me.
All right, welcome to the way that I normally do the little pate puzzle. Okay, witness these guys for 1 second. All right, or just destroy them. That's fine.
I'm sorry, but okay. I know they just hack at the tree.
You know why?
This looks like the giant boss.
Well, it's a giant, yeah. I mean, if you know anything about the lore of the area that we're in, this is the old castle that's falling apart, and there's a big war with the giants and the soldiers here. And at this fort is where a lot of the battle took place, so this is a dead giant. And these soldiers in Hollowing have forgotten everything but their one purpose, their one burning rage to destroy the enemies that, you know, ultimately led this keep to ruin. So they're like basically insane and like blindly attacking the dead corpse of the foe that they've already killed. It's kind of fun.
That's a good piece of hidden lore there. I didn't even notice that. I just thought they were trying to just hack at it because
it is. There's a reason for it, man. Well, I'm not gonna spoil it, but you'll see why. I'm not gonna spoil. Don't spoil.
Okay.
All right. So basically, the way I do Pate's puzzle is I come up this ladder here instead of going the way you did, and I roll down here. Mm-hmm. Don't do it though. And then you can do the whole thing backwards, which makes the thing a lot easier because they're all unaware that you're coming at them.
Oh.
So you can get rid of them a little bit easier. Okay. But this way, you can also get, you know, some of these people down here, get that light crossbow and whatnots.
Ooh.
I'm about to show you another really cool thing about this Scholar of the First Sin thing.
Okay.
Are you with me? Are you here? You got the crossbow?
I'm here. I got it, yeah. I didn't cook it yet, but I have it.
Come over here and let me, you know, let's sit by the fire and get warmed by a tail here.
What is that?
What's what?
This.
What's what? What
this
are you talking
about?
That's my shadow. That's my shadow.
Exactly what I'm talking about.
What are you talking about, man?
I'm clipping on it. I am bumping into this thing. I am falling over this thing that looks like a person's shadow.
I wonder what that is. It seems like a dude chilling there. There's no harm, no foul, yeah?
No.
Okay.
Nothing happened.
Why don't you stop being such a good guy and show this man who's the boss?
Okay. All right. Well, it was a corpse. He's no longer there. He was invisible. Why? Smooth and silky stone.
So now we've been introduced very smartly to another mechanic. Lights in this game plays a much bigger difference than it did in the base game. To the point where there are invisible enemies that you can only see by lighting up their shadows on the wall that give you hidden goodies. It's never bad. I always, this is my motto for Dark Souls 2 Scholar of the First Sin. It's never bad to go in with a torch. Never a bad idea. Now this here's a kind of a tricky jump. And I didn't even make it there, so.
Oh, well, neither did I.
Yeah, there's a good item up there, I think, so you might want that eventually. I just got fucking parried, man! You see that OG parry? Oh my god, dude. I've never seen that happen before, man. They totally fucked me there. Unbelievable.
That was great.
It was pretty good. At the end of this playthrough, we'll do some PvP, see if we can... See, parrying in Dark Souls 2, I think, is the hardest out of the entire series. it's real. There's a really small window for parrying. It's pretty rough, actually. All right, now that we're here, we can roll down.
I kind of want to see if I can grab that item.
Yeah, it's probably a good idea. Do your exploratory whatnot. You'll have to basically go all the way back up the ladder and all the way back around. So here we are. Come
Let's
with
go
me.
Go ahead and scurry up here.
That's right, scurry up there.
Oh, wait,
I like that
I have
word.
The 4,000, I have the 4,000 souls.
Great. You can buy yourself a little stone there.
I will go buy myself some stone.
So it's easier if you run on, like, head on, like I just did. Not by the corner. Nope. I guess that's what I'm saying. Don't try and go for the corner. Just go for the actual side.
All right. One more time.
That's it. That's all you need.
It's more with feelings.
This one, exactly. Put some freaking effort into it.
All right.
It's time to go, 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 go.
I'm gonna go ahead and hike those elbows.
That's right.
Get back over there.
Getting some good form.
All right.
All right, now watch me do it first. I'm here. I start here. I'm facing the actual flat side. Okay, well, that didn't work, so do it better than me.
Okay. All right, let's do it. We're doing this. Why am I going down?
I don't know, man. You got to do it at the right time.
Okay. One last time, and then if not, then we're going to go forward, and I'm going to come back later on.
No problem.
Or do I want to go get that rock first?
That rock? Are you talking about smoking crack cocaine? I thought we talked about this again. What are you talking about?
No, the Pharaoh Stone.
Oh, no, I think we should beat the boss and then you can treat yourself to whatever goodies you want.
Okay. Got it. Cool. Soul and a torch.
That's my boy.
Alright, so I'm going to pop this here life gem. Because for some reason falling off of this ledge has taken a toll on my life.
Yeah, drop damage is, or fall damage in this game is absurdly
brutal.
You know, yeah, well, yeah, pretty much. That's pretty realistic here. Alright.
Okay. Life gem and homeward bone, and you're in a fight. All right, that's cool.
Got one. Hey, like a boss.
Hey. Wreck that guy's face.
There it
None
is.
None of that. Get that
now,
out
there
of
is
here.
There is a shield break critical attack that you can do. You know that, yeah?
Really?
Yeah, so you break their shield, and then if you walk up and hit R1 at the right time, you can get, like, a parry-type animation.
All right.
So keep that in mind. This, okay, I want you to kind of, like, a lot of this, the lore of this area is about understanding, like, the architecture that you're walking on. So just, like, where are we right now?
It looks like we're on the outskirts, and we're on a giant, so, oh, okay, this guy. How dare you interrupt my loring? Okay, well, they want to fight on the blade. You go down. That's where you stay. And one of them lived. One of them lived? No, he's dead.
I don't think so. He should be done. So, yeah, this here is a giant sword, as you can clearly see. Now, if you, funnily enough, if you take a look to the left while you're here, left and up, you see the statue.
Oh, that is missing a hand.
And the hand, which is right in front of our faces.
So what happened here? It looks like this thing was picked up and stabbed into the wall.
It's, you know, there's some shit going on. Also, if you look off to the right where we're at here, you'll notice another statue of a guard.
And he's missing a head.
So let's just keep that in mind and let's move on.
All right. I've come to the understanding that guards don't have it easy here.
they really don't, man. They probably don't get paid enough for their work.
Oh.
Yeah, I forgot about this guy.
Nope. I think I don't want to be behind him for some reason. Like,
well,
that,
he does
that shield.
Yeah, he does do a little backfall.
Okay. That's good to know.
So the cool thing about this game that a lot of people overlooked as far as AI goes is that the AI is actually programmed to learn from your actions and react to you. So,
really?
Yeah, they showed this off in the first demo of Dark Souls 2, like, before the game came out, where basically, and that's what you see in the game here, is that if you go around these enemies, like, trying to backstab them, like, a lot of people try to backstab fish, mm-hmm. like, with the turtles, they learn from, like, what you're trying to do, and they fall on their back to try and flatten you. With people that, like, with other kinds of characters, they start to, like, move differently if they think that you're gonna, like, try and backstack them. They'll put their shield up more often. That kind of stuff. If you try to, like, if you, like, R1 spam a lot, they'll learn from that, and they'll start to, like, parry you. And it's kind of like a dynamic AI system, which is really cool.
You can't just go in at sword swinging. I get you.
Yeah, it'll adapt to your playstyle to make it even tougher for you. And we're back. In the new you.
Right.
So if you come off over here. If you remember, there used to be a little treasure bug here. They moved those around too in this game. And down here is where you're going to find a better shield than what you've got right now.
I have a large leather shield.
That is correct. I like that a lot better than the blue wooden.
All right. Large leather shield is 90% blockage. Yeah, replace.
And good stability,
and I'm
too.
I'm still not high level. Indeed. Okay, there's an item you just rolled past.
Yeah, come over here. Let's keep rocking.
Alright.
Here is the shortcut. Pop it. Now, if you want, we can go rest because the bonfire's right up there, and then we can take on the boss. What do you think?
I'm going to go and buy that stone before I lose my souls.
All right. You do what you need to.
I don't think I need to rest, though. I haven't used up too many of my health items. Like, I still have my Estus, and I have plenty of stones.
You might as well. I will, here.
Oh, no, yeah, because to reset my durability on the weapons.
You might as well do a bunch of stuff, yeah. So I'll black crystal out here. So far, okay, I know we're kind of like an hour, maybe 2 hours deep into the game. What do you think about Dark Souls 2? I know this is like stuff you've already played so far, but we're going to get into some stuff that you haven't seen in a bit, and that'll be fun. But what do you think about the game? Still tough?
It's hard, yes. It's not as hard as I remember it because I recently played the Dark Souls game, so I'm like, okay, there's going to be this and there's going to be that, and these things are going to be unavoidable, so they don't frustrate me as much. So if I go in with a cool head, it's a little bit easier to adapt. But I'm pretty sure I'm going to start freaking out when I see more of the stuff I haven't seen yet.
There's some crazy stuff in this game, man.
Yeah, like when they announced this game, it was they were boasting about how it's going to mess with your fears. And I don't want to see any spiders. I don't.
All right, let's put the game down right now. Then let's never speak of it again.
No, there's spiders.
I'm not gonna say anything. In fact, I really am not gonna say anything. I'm not gonna tell you if there are spiders or not spiders, but there are creepy things in the game. Pretty nasty enemies.
Okay. Like what?
Nope. Not happening.
You're not gonna loop me in?
You don't deserve it. I want your first reaction to be, you know, I want to see behind those hazel eyes.
I see what you did there.
Thank you. I appreciate that. A lot of people don't get my references, but they're on the fly and they happen all the time.
They do. All right. I'm going to give my Estus Shard to this lady here. There's the Joker is next to me.
The Joker?
Somebody's cosplaying him.
What are you talking about?
Somebody's cosplaying him as the Joker.
Oh, you're... Yeah, you're gonna get some spoiled armor types, but that's not a big deal.
No, I mean, it's just like... He wasn't wearing anything flashy, but his
just
face
the jester
was all
outfit,
white.
Or?
No, his hair was all white. Face was all white and green hair.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to hit this level up button.
You should do that, because you've got enough juice to do so.
Yeah, I'm going to flashily put something into vigor, because I don't like my health being at 4.
Yeah, health is, health's important. In this game, attunement, if you're going to be a roly kind of guy, is very important. I normally...
Attunement?
Yeah, very, very, very important. I normally, when I'm leveling up my character, I level up attunement, vitality, vigor, strength, and endurance. Those are, like, the main, like, most important... switch strength with dexterity if you're going to be more of a dex guy, but you get the gist.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the adaptability perk basically, like, extends your iframes for your roll, your invincibility frames. I think we talked about that a little bit earlier.
A couple days ago, right? Okay.
So it's definitely important.
I believe I will be putting more points into that.
It's a good thing.
I thought it was
only
for spells.
Yeah, if you can get your adaptability up to like 22, that's probably where you need to, like, you don't need any more than that.
Okay, so adaptability will go up to that. And I was thinking attunement. Attunements for spells, carry more spells.
I don't think you need to worry about attunement at the moment unless you have like a spell that you're dying to use.
Nope. I think I remember reading somewhere that I need 10 attunement to even have one spell
to get a
slot.
Yeah, but you, like, I wouldn't waste your points on attunement at the moment.
I don't think I will. I mean, attunement, I'm at 6. That's a lot.
Yeah, it's a lot. You need 4 more points. To you, that's a ton of souls.
Yeah.
Now you do have the key as well. I know you're in Majulia. Might as well open up the door for Lenegrast.
Yeah, you remind me. I thought I already teleported back.
Old Shrek, man. Well, don't worry about that. You can do it next time, I suppose.
Okay. So I'm back here.
Okay.
At the bonfire with the hag.
Okay.
I'm gonna go ahead and exhaust her dialogue.
That's a good plan.